insight is fading. It is being wiped off the planet it was ordered to thoroughly investigate. 4 years have passed since InSight and Mars began their battle. The InSight lander has repeatedly used sophisticated instruments to pry out the planet's deepest secrets in an effort to penetrate its core with metal and a hammer. But from the beginning, Mars fought back with a never-ending assault, choking the light from InSight's components and making it helpless. It did this by utilizing a seemingly harmless weapon that kept building. However, not before InSight discovered what it was looking for. It has discovered information that has improved our knowledge of Mars and the solar system. And now, let's take a closer look of the InSight mission and its findings, as it begins to shut down completely because this may be the last time we do so. But much like a good thriller film, this story has one more twist to it. The most significant of all of InSight's messages to us may turn out to be those that it sends when it is fading. So stay tuned till the end of this video, as SpaceX CEO Elon Musk will help us unravel the mysteries behind InSight's Mars lander's mission and what he found out that left him in shock. Hello everyone, welcome back to Elon Musk Evolution, where we bring you the most recent news about Elon Musk and his multi-billion dollar companies, space news, and the latest science and technology. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss any of our amazing videos. According to Musk, InSight touched down on Mars on November 26, 2018. Its goal was to investigate Mars' core in order to help us comprehend the planet's composition and potential formation process 4 billion years ago. This would help us understand the other three rocky planets in our solar system, including Mercury, Venus, and even our own Earth, as Mars is one of them. Mars, on the other hand, was InSight's antagonist, and Mars was not one to readily disclose its secrets. InSight would lose battles before it would win the war. And through its sensors, the first defeat happened. For data collection, InSight has two main sensors. The first is a seismograph called Seis that is intended to find even the smallest tremors in the crust that might be caused by meteorite strikes or earthquakes on Mars, Musk says. The second was a heat flow and radiometer sensor package mounted on a mole, a device that digs by hammering. InSight's mole immediately discovered that it was difficult to reach the 3 to 5 meters depth required to obtain accurate data due to natural variations in the Martian soil from what was measured for back on Earth. In actuality, it was only barely able to penetrate the surface. Over the course of more than 2 years, researchers sought to find a way to get the mole to dig. But in January 2021, they decided to abandon that part of the operation. As a result, the Seis remained the primary tool used by scientists to examine the planet's core. This was accomplished by paying attention to the P and S waves of Mars quakes. The planet's crust, core, and mantle all experience ripple effects when Mars quakes occur. Some of the waves may bounce back towards the surface when they encounter the points where these three parts converge. In other words, when Seis hears the quake's rumblings, it frequently also detects a lot of secondary echoes from the same quake. It is possible to learn crucial details about the size, shape, and density of Mars' internal by measuring the time and magnitude of these secondary echoes. InSight, however, was under a time crunch. The enemy of NASA made an unflattering appearance. You guessed it, dust is an unassuming but sneaky weapon of destruction. If you reach this part of the video, stay tuned till the end of the video, cause we will be unfolding all the mysteries of the Red Planet. Two sizable solar panels were used in the construction of InSight, a stationary lander, to provide it with the power it would require for the duration of its 2-year mission. However, scientists were aware of the challenges they would face, including dust, when the mission was extended to a 4-year mission. Dust may appear harmless, but if it landed on the solar cells, it might entirely obstruct InSight's capacity to gather energy. More dust did just that during the course of the 4 years. These panels might have generated 5,000 watt-hours every Martian day at the start of the trip. They can now only generate 500 watt-hours, which is around 10 minutes worth of electricity for an electric oven. Without that kind of energy, InSight would be unable to maintain its heaters, leaving its parts exposed to the minus 70 degrees Celsius temperatures of Martian nights, which would quickly destroy them. InSight was not built with inbuilt fans or cleaners. Instead, they had counted on cleaning events in which tiny Martian whirlwinds or dust devils would appear and sweep away extra dust. Unfortunately, despite the fact that these windy disturbances were seen, they did not approach frequently enough to adequately clean InSight's panels. InSight began to shut down in 2021 as a result. But scientists weren't going to let this happen, so in early June 2021, they developed an obviously illogical method of cleaning the panels of dust, adding more dust. InSight doesn't have any cleaning equipment, but it does have a little robotic arm with a scoop that it may use to pick up sand from the ground around it. The plan was to use the Martian wind to gradually pour sand from the scoop onto the panels, Musk explained. Ideally, the wind would cause the sand to bounce off the edges of the panels as it fell, and as the sand struck the panel, it would push dust loose, eliminating it. Though the idea may seem absurd in principle, it really worked, giving the lander an extra 30 watt-hours of power each day. This changed everything by extending InSight's mission into the summer of 2021 and the next year. Only in the last year of InSight's life, after it should have passed away, did it notice its biggest Mars quakes. InSight's lander picked up more than 1,300 Martian quakes during the course of the mission. These Mars quakes mostly had minor magnitudes, Musk explained. The lower size of Mars prevents the crust from being divided into multiple plates, which means that it lacks plate tectonics, the process by which one plate pushes against or submerges another, causing some of the most powerful earthquakes on Earth. If you weren't standing directly on top of the epicenter of a Mars earthquake, which most invariably registers below a magnitude 4 on the Richter scale, you probably wouldn't even be aware it happened. Are you still here? From what we have covered so far, do you think life form really exists on Mars? Comment down below. Fortunately, while detecting such tiny quakes is highly challenging on Earth, it is much easier on Mars. And InSight's Seis instrument is equipped to detect Mag 4 quakes from as far away as approximately 1,000 kilometers. Mars is quieter than Earth. Oceans on Earth are continually moving back and forth, which causes vibrations that can entirely conceal smaller earthquakes. Mars, meanwhile, certainly has no such issue. Nevertheless, scientists hope to detect some Mars quakes that were more powerful than Mag 4. The best images of what was happening beneath Mars' crust would be provided by these events. This hope was not fulfilled for the majority of InSight's mission, but in May 2022, there was a rumble. A Mag 5 Mars quake, the greatest yet, was detected by data streamed in by InSight's Seis sensor. This important data item would not have been heard if InSight had already shut down. Therefore, NASA had deemed the InSight mission a great success. It has produced information that will open the way for numerous upcoming missions. However, what can we conclude from the previous communication and the ones that came before it? What can we learn about Mars from the information provided? Starting with the fact that Mars does indeed have a crust, a mantle, and a core, exactly like the Earth, we now know this because to InSight's data. We weren't prepared for the crust to be that thin. As opposed to the Earth's, which may reach a thickness of 70 kilometers, it has 2 to 3 sublayers and is 20 to 37 kilometers deep. Although it drops another 1,560 kilometers, its mantle is not as heated as previously thought. Lastly, it has a core with an 1,830 kilometer radius, which is larger than scientists had anticipated. It is also less thick than previously anticipated, which is unexpected, Musk stated. Scientists now believe that it must contain lighter elements like carbon, oxygen, sulfur, and hydrogen, instead of just being composed of nickel and iron, as the Earth's core is. This is an interesting realization. It explains why Mars' molten core is still present. These lighter elements lower the freezing point of Mars' core in a manner similar to how salt lowers the freezing point of ice, which is why grit is often spread on roads during cold weather. It also suggests where the planet came from. Even though scientists now have a general idea of Mars' internal structure, some previously held beliefs that have been refuted by InSight's discoveries. For instance, a hotspot of magma that feeds the volcanic processes we witness in this region lies beneath the highly volcanic region of Mars' surface known as Tharsis, which is home to Olympus Mons, a volcano that is 2.5 times taller than Mount Everest. Finally, InSight can relax when it shuts down and closes its eyes while looking at Mars' scattered clouds and sandy plains. It completed the mission for which it was sent. Finally, the inner workings of Mars are revealed. Are you concerned that our world might one day resemble Mars? Help us battle climate change, please. If you can, plant more trees. And that ends today's episode. Please subscribe and don't forget to like today's video. We'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.